I was sitting at my battered old computer doing homework when I felt my mom put her hands over my eyes and giggle from behind me. I could tell she was smiling when she told me to get up and to not sneak a peek. I started going through a mental calendar when I realized I forgot about my own birthday. If you like these stories, make sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons below, as well as the notifications bell, so you're the first to know when a new story is out. My mom led me to the dining table, which she decorated with all sorts of birthday stuff, like cheesy balloons and napkins of all colors with the number 18 all over them. "Blow out the candles, Miles," smiled my mom. I blew out the 18 little candles and made my wish. I know it's stupid, but it's the one little superstition I allow myself. I wished to be so successful I could buy my mom and each of my siblings their own house and take care of them like my good-for-nothing dad never did. You're probably thinking this is the typical story of a poor kid with a heart of gold, the kind of guy who's loved by everyone but is really unlucky. Well, that's not me. It all started in high school. Instead of playing sports and going to parties all the time, I kept to myself. When I walked through the halls of my school, I didn't wave at anyone, didn't do some cheesy handshake with pals, and definitely didn't stuff anyone in a locker. I laughed to myself whenever I saw those things, because they all looked so pointless. During class, I sat at the back and didn't say a word. I didn't even pay attention most of the time, but I still had the best grades in the school because I worked hard on the side. All of that, of course, was ruined when she entered my life. My old history teacher had just retired, so I was expecting someone exactly like him to take his place. I could not have been more wrong. First came the sound of stilettos clacking on the floor. Then a soft summer breeze wafted in her perfume. I still get the chills every time I hear heels clacking on the floor, and I gag when I smell similar perfume. She walked in slow motion. First came one leg, then the other followed suit. And soon enough, time stopped for every guy in my fourth period history class. She was every guy's dream woman. "My name is Mrs. Michaels. I'll be teaching you the history of the world from now on," she spoke while writing her name on the board and underlining it harshly. Every guy audibly gulped. I was distracted by Miss Michaels at first too, but it didn't last. A few minutes later, I was back to minding my business and scribbling absentmindedly in a notebook, while the rest of the class opened the windows because the guys were sweating and the girls were fuming. "What are you, too good to pay attention in my class?" asked Miss Michaels. "No, miss," I said. She told me that if she caught me not paying attention again, she'd give me detention, but I knew she wouldn't do it. She had the vibe of someone who was all bark and no bite. My grades in history absolutely died. What kind of teacher grades on participation? Just to spite her, I started sitting at the very front of the class. I even bought fake glasses to make myself look more intellectual. I asked at least a dozen questions each class, and she asked them to me too. Our history classes became basically just me and her having a duel to see who could get the other to quit being annoying first. Everyone enjoyed the show. My classmates actually started talking to me. We had an individual presentation due, which I was ready for weeks in advance. It was the best performance of my life. I definitely deserved to have roses thrown at my feet. "Any questions, miss?" I asked Miss Michaels with a lifted eyebrow as she glared at me. She started picking at every word I had said, but I answered each question and had reasoning for everything I said. I didn't even notice when it happened, but suddenly we were standing mere inches apart. We suddenly realized we had an audience, so we fell apart and I sat back down as she straightened her skirt and asked the next person to do their presentation. Miss Michaels slipped a note in my locker. It said, "Meet me at this address at 3 o'clock on Saturday. You desperately need tutoring lessons." I tried to hide the note as quickly as possible, but a classmate saw the pink paper and snatched it out of my hands. Soon enough, I had a horde of guys from my grade asking how I got the teacher to drool for me. I told them I had no idea what they were talking about and left. But I couldn't wipe the stupid grin off my face the rest of the day. I was at Miss Michaels' house that weekend. She led me straight to the dining room table when I got to her house, and she had loads of food and drinks for me. She spent the entire 2-hour tutoring session talking nonstop. "Do you know why every male student is suddenly failing my class?" she asked me. I shrugged at her and stuffed a cookie into my mouth, wiping the crumbs on my pants and putting my stuff back into my bag because it was getting kinda late. She saw me do this and grabbed my hand. She led me to the glass door that led to her backyard. "My yard is a mess and the pool desperately needs cleaning," she said nonchalantly, but she had clearly brought me to look at it for a reason. "Listen, I know about your family situation, Miles," she said, brushing the hair away from my eyes with her fingers. Why don't you do a few chores around here for me, and I'll pay you a decent amount of money? She had this look on her face. It was a weird one. There was something in her eyes that told me she had some sort of a plan in mind, but she was right. My mom and I were barely making enough money to pay our rent, so the idea of some extra cash was exciting. I told Miss Michaels I'd be down to help her out, and she smiled at me and called me a good boy before leading me out the door. I started doing stuff around Miss Michaels' house. I took on the little projects that a stereotypical husband would do, like building a shed in the backyard, but I also cleaned her pool every week and mowed her lawn. One time, I was cleaning her pool while she was sunbathing. I kept hearing this buzzing sound, thinking it was a bug, but then Miss Michaels gasped and looked up at the sky. There was a drone flying over her, and I could see the little camera. I tried knocking it out of the sky with multiple objects and chased after it when it started leaving. It landed in somebody's yard, and since they felt alright invading a woman's privacy like that, I didn't care if I invaded theirs, so I hopped over the fence into their backyard. I was surprised to find it was one of my stupid classmates. I didn't think I could take a 6'1" bodybuilder creep out, so I was relieved to see it was a lanky guy like me. I saw the remote in his hand and pounced on him. Miss Michaels arrived a few minutes later to pull me off the guy. She took me back to her place and told me to hop in the shower since I was muddy from rolling around on the floor with my classmate. She got me a clean set of clothes, and by the time I came downstairs, she had the table set all fancy and a big meal on it too. My stomach started growling. Miss Michaels told me to sit down and eat. She started running her fingers up and down my lower arm, and suddenly she reminded me a lot of girls my age and the way they flirt, giggling and batting their eyelashes. Before I knew it, she leaned in and kissed me. "You look just like your dad," she said and kissed me again. It took me a second to register, but then I heard a record scratch. My eyes shot open, and suddenly I wasn't into it. I excused myself, saying I had to use the bathroom, then started freaking out. "What the hell? What am I supposed to say to that?" I thought. "How does she even know my dad?" I needed something to calm me down, so I started digging through her cabinets to see if she had something. My hand touched what felt like a plastic bag. I couldn't see it, but I pulled it out and saw it was a stack of photos. I recognized her in the first picture, and guess who was sitting next to her with his arm around her? It was my dad. They looked young, around my age. I started flipping through the pictures. There were some of them laughing, hanging out, and kissing. Crap, I thought. This woman dated my deadbeat dad, and now she wants me in his place. Things were a bit awkward after that. I tried to make up excuses to not go to her house, but Miss Michaels offered to pay me more, so I gave in. She kissed me goodbye every time I left, and sometimes would rub my shoulders or offer to give me a massage. I was still super into her though, and it was pretty cool to be the guy the hot teacher was into. I wouldn't say we were dating, but we did most things that two people who were dating do. I started getting attached, but not more than her. She could call and text me all the time and ask me to come over a lot. One day, I had to cancel on her because I got invited to a party, and for once, I wanted to go. I didn't like parties, but I also never got invited to them. Now that the teacher everyone wanted had the hots for me, every guy wanted to be my friend, and I got invited to parties. I showed up to the party just to find out what all the fuss was about, and soon realized absolutely nothing. It was horrible. I couldn't hear anyone talk, and I hated having people rubbing all over me. I heard there was a basement and snuck down there quickly. As I went down the stairs, the music got quieter, so I sighed in relief. But then I heard a familiar laugh. There was a wall that separated the basement into two sections. I took a peek around the wall, and guess who I saw? Miss Michaels. She was sitting on an old couch with a classmate of mine. She had her hand on his knee and was laughing at something he said. She then put her hand on his jaw and whispered loud enough that I could hear, "You look just like your dad," before kissing him. I don't even know what I felt in that moment. Anger, disgust, sadness? I leaned on the wall and looked at the couple kissing. I then cleared my throat to make myself known. And when I saw the look of shock on Miss Michael's face, I said, "You're unbelievable," and stormed out. I ran out of the party without saying goodbye to anyone, but I wasn't alone, of course. Miss Michaels came running after me, apologizing and trying to get me to listen to her.
"Miles, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt you,"
she cried. She had thick mascara running down her cheeks.
"How can I make it up to you? I'll do anything," she begged,
which is when I got an idea. I knew for a fact that a woman like her had connections, and if she was a teacher, it was the type of connections I needed. I told her I would forgive her, but she had to get me into a college of my choice. She wiped her tears and nodded, saying she could definitely do that. She tried to kiss me, but I turned around and walked away,
telling her to talk to me when I was accepted. It's not uncommon for a kid like me to get a fully paid scholarship to one of the best colleges in the country, so a celebration was in order, of course. I didn't have the money to throw a party, so I asked the school, and they let me arrange a movie night for my classmates and their families on the football field, using the school's equipment. Everyone was having a blast, and I was sitting next to Miss Michaels with my arm around her shoulder. I nudged her and told her to go hit play on my laptop for the movie to play. When she did, her face fell and her eyes started filling with tears. On the screen, everyone saw pictures of Miss Michaels with all her senior boyfriends. Every boy's parents looked at them angrily, but mostly at her. Next, only the moms looked upset because they saw pictures of Miss Michaels when she was younger, dating their husbands. See, she made the mistake of stashing pictures of her ex-boyfriends all over the house, and allowing me into said house gave me access to them. Because she wasn't very smart about where she hid them, I had just exposed her plan. She was dating the sons of every man she dated in college who lived here and had legal sons. Maybe it was some desperate way to get closure, but it was sick nonetheless. Of course, she was fired soon after. I can't think of a single family she didn't affect in some way. Although, her effect on my family was positive. "You're nothing like your father," said my mom proudly as we walked off that field, surrounded by arguing families. "You actually have a future," she said, smiling and ruffling my hair. She was right. Thanks to my psycho teacher, I had a bright future ahead of me.